And now, it's time for Southern California's sports fishing voice. Let's Talk Hookup. For the next 2 hours, join Pete Gray, Rock Cod Rick Maxa, Corey Sandin, and this week's special expert guest for fishing information, new techniques to catch more fish, and the most current scoop on what's happening in the water. Let's Talk Hookup is sponsored in part by Ford, the official truck of Let's Talk Hookup, and Shimano Rods and Reels. Fish with the best. Shimano. Get ready for the fastest 2 hours on radio with the hosts of Let's Talk Hookup, Pete Gray, Rock Cod Rick Maxa, and Corey Sandin.
I'm Pete Gray. Rock Cod Rick Maxa is injured, and it's just me and Captain Art Taylor of The Searcher here in the world headquarters, and we're pretty excited and very, very happy to have Art because the fish are biting, and we're ready to rock and roll. So you stay tuned. This is Southern California Sport Fishing Voice. It's Let's Talk Hookup on the Let's Talk Hookup app and the Mightier 1090 ESPN Radio.
You've heard all about it. You know the anglers catching fish have it, so what's holding you back? It's a fact. Fishdope.com really does help you catch more fish and burn less fuel. Fishdope.com is the only fish finding service with a spotter plane along with a crew of top anglers on the water almost every day that report actual locations and catches. You can get daily catch reports from Point Conception to San Martin Island 365 days a year. Fishdope.com is for everyone, whether you have your own boat, fish on your friend's boat, or a sport boat. Fishdope.com has online planning tools, moon phase, tides, hot bite icons, and more. So bottom line is, if you don't have fishdope.com, well, you're probably missing a lot of bites. Membership costs less than $50 of gas, and that's for the entire year. That's right, 1 year. What a bargain. Plus, use the special code to save $20 on a new fishdope.com membership. Check it out today. Fishdope.com. Catch more fish, burn less fuel.
The future comes standard at your San Diego County Ford dealers, so swing on by and check out the legendary Ford F-150, the smart and capable Ford Ranger, and the all-new Ford Bronco Sport. New inventory is arriving daily, and your San Diego County Ford dealer is here to help you build and order the truck or SUV of your dreams. Want to make sure you get the right truck to tow your boat? They'll help you order the right configuration to meet your needs. Want to make sure you get the right SUV to haul your gear on your next adventure? They've got you covered there too. Escape, Edge, Bronco Sport, Explorer, and Expedition. They've got the SUV that's perfect for you. If it isn't on the lot, they'll order it and get you exactly what you need. They want you to trade, so swing by your nearest San Diego County Ford dealer or visit buyfordnow.com to see all the great deals. They'll be glad to hook you up. Welcome back to Let's Talk Hookup right here in the Mightier 1090 ESPN Radio and the Let's Talk Hookup app. Pete Gray here. As I said, Rock Cod Rick Max is under the weather today, so we have a great show lined up for you today. Captain Art Taylor from The Search. Good morning, Art.
Good morning, Pete. Thanks for having me.
Hey, thanks for coming here. Of course, we're overlooking the in the world headquarters here of all the busy San Diego landing, Shogun, XL pulling in, and oh my gosh, you just watch these boats unloading. I saw The Searcher unloading yesterday, along with the Royal Polaris and the Royal Star. How do they have so many bins for so many fish, man? It's like they had to buy extra bins, I think, this week.
Yeah, the processors are a little bit on the ropes, but, you know, they'll handle it. They have in the past, and they will in the future, and so I think that they're prepared.
Yeah. No, make sure you make your reservations.
That's key. Yeah. That's key. You make a reservation on a trip. The next call you should make or the next thing you should do would be make a reservation with your processor.
Good point. Yeah. So if you're booking a trip for 2023, book your processing for 2023.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. That way it's, you know, out of the way. You don't have to worry about it. You know, they take reservations for how many people they can successfully do same day service for, right. And if you're not one of those people, then they can most likely take your fish, but you're not going to get it same day.
Yeah, for sure. Or yeah. Even, and sometimes they can't even take your fish, like right
sometimes,
now.
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah. Well, Searcher, you've been catching them. You and Mike, man, Captain Mike, and yourself have been out there, and it's such good fishing. What's going on?
Well, you know, this yellowtail that's on kelp patties, and the grade, the quality is just phenomenal, and it's, you know, it's been sustainable here. It's happening now for the last 3 or 4 weeks.
Yeah.
And it's close by. It's within 50 miles of Point Loma. And so you find the right kelp patty, it's really, really good action. Fly line a sardine or yo-yo jig down to depth there. And a Salus 6X Junior, blue and white, of course.
Really?
And it's really, really good fishing. And then if you're on a trip that goes out to the west there in between San Clemente and Catalina Island, there's tons and tons and tons of bluefin, and they're primarily the 40 to 100-pound fish.
Nice.
And there's, you know, a great big school of those big ones out there on Tanner Bank, so that's something that
another option.
Yeah.
So there's a spread of fish no matter which way you point, north, south, east, well, not east, but west.
And then on top of that, there's massive schools of bluefin, yellowfin, tuna mix, you know, within our local banks here, the 302 and the 425 and the 371, there's big breezers, you know, schools up on top and foamers and that sort of stuff in that area too. So, I mean, there's some fish around.
Yeah. And what's going on? Is it just the bait? It's just here because there's such an abundance of bait? The ocean's so healthy?
You know, we talk about this just about every time I'm here. It's all about food source.
Yeah.
They're happy. There's a food source there for them, and they're happy where they're at because there's plenty of food.
Yeah.
And water temperature is to their liking. And so, I mean, for months now, that fish has been around, and it's super encouraging. It's really, really great to have that resource right here in our backyard.
Yeah, no kidding. So water temperature, you mentioned that. It varies. You look at the terrafin charts, going from 74 degrees to 68, 69 degrees. It's like it's all over the board, right?
Yeah, it is. And that, you know, keep in mind, that's surface temperature.
Yeah.
That's what terrafin is giving you, is surface temperature.
Yeah.
And so I think, yeah, they spend some time at the surface, and when they're up feeding and producing those foamers and that sort of stuff, then you know, they're up on the surface for you know, however long they need to be, and then maybe they're down there at, you know, 150 feet where it's cooler.
Yeah, because bluefin like it cooler.
Definitely, yeah.
What about all this Dorado, too? It's like John Ireland used to say, they're like vermin. They're all over the place, right?
Yeah, and it seems as though that, you know, the numbers are increasing. I know a couple weeks ago we were seeing kelps that had Dorado on them and they weren't biting, and now all of a sudden they're starting to bite.
They're growing. They grow so fast.
Yeah.
It's like not surprising that they start to grow pretty quickly, right?
Yeah. And I think that that's just, you know, we've had those, what, 3 hurricanes in a row now, mm-hmm. and that's pushed up warmer water. And we've had calm weather. We haven't had any wind, thankfully, for a while. So that helps, and so that makes the sea surface temperature higher. So.
For sure. Little wind event right now, but it's supposed to get better next week, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Right back to nicer weather. And
yes, that's what the forecast says.
Yeah, that's a good thing. So most of the bait that these fish are on, is it anchovy? Are they balls of anchovy?
You know, it's so small, it's really hard to,
you know, what it is.
To pinpoint exactly what it is. And to be honest, you know, I haven't cut open one of those bluefin tuna and opened up their stomach to see exactly what they're feeding on. But that's, you know, it's not visible. I mean, it's something small that they're enjoying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you just have to convince them to eat sardine.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how has the bait been from the Everingham brothers?
You know, it's been, you know, consistently good. I think that they had a little hiccup a couple, 3 weeks ago where they had maybe a bad load or something like that. And so they scrambled and got everybody taken care of and then replenished it. And, of course, they're always doing maintenance to those boxes out there. That's a 24/7 type thing. And so You know, overall, Irvingham, what would we do without them?
Oh, they're just incredible, the job that they do, and to be able to locate and the quantity of bait that they need to catch to fulfill all the needs of the fleet.
Yeah, it's, and they've been doing it for decades now.
I know.
So, yeah, we're really, really blessed to have Irvingham Brothers.
Isn't that the truth, for sure? Well, for those of our listeners that aren't familiar with the Searcher, tell us about the Searcher.
95 feet, air-conditioned cabins, you know, wooden construction. RSW system to keep your fish at 30 or 31 degrees. It goes in the hole as soon as you catch it, and you know, that system preserves your catch until you make it back to the dock to give it to those processors, and you know, it's sushi quality fish. We take good care of the fish that goes in the well before it goes in the well, and you know, we take good care of it when it gets back to the dock too, so it's
for sure.
And then, you know, this is, the boat's 53 years old now.
Wow.
1970 was launched in 1970. And this is my 40th year.
On the boat.
On the boat, yeah.
Wow. Yep. So tell us about the history of the boat. Cape Polaris originally,
Built for Bill Poole, Dittmar and Donaldson in Costa Mesa, launched in Newport Beach. And
You still have those photos up on your website of the transfer when it went from Dittmar Donaldson down
Newport Boulevard? I think that, you know, those are probably in the archives somewhere. But yeah.
Pretty classic photos.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Driving down Newport Boulevard, right?
Down
to Newport Beach to launch it.
Yeah, that was quite an undertaking.
Yeah.
But it was something that Dittmar and Donaldson did all the time. You know, they built so many sport fishing boats when they were in business, and were one of the ones that's left.
Yeah, and there's still quite a few of them left because they built them pretty well. The construction is double plank mahogany, is that right?
Ours is double plank mahogany. Yeah. There's still some single plank boats out there, but ours is double plank mahogany. Yeah, glued and screwed. It's a tank.
It's a tank, and it rides so incredibly well. And the other advantage that I know from the Searcher and riding many, many boats is it's quiet.
It is a little bit quiet. It's a little softer ride. It's not, you know, metal boats are rigid. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's like all the boats kind of ride the same. You know, when it's choppy, we're all going to roll around a little.
Sure.
And but, it's a good riding boat, and it's safe, and it's, you know, been in service now for 53 years, and there's no reason why it can't be around for another 53.
Well, you and Celia keep it in ace shape. I mean, you guys, you know, haul the boat every year, do heavy maintenance if required, which isn't always, but
true.
You guys really keep it in great shape, and that's the secret, right?
You know, we have a lot of pride in that boat.
Yeah.
And it's provided us with you know, a great career, and so, you know, we got to take care of it. We got to take care of our investment, and you know, it's just a fantastic boat, and so why wouldn't you take care of it?
Yeah, absolutely, it is. So, tell us about your crew, Captain Mike, and the crew.
Mike Totter, he's been running the boat now. This is his third season. I'm the relief guy now. Mike runs it the majority of the time, and he's just doing a fantastic job. And he gets better and better every trip. He learns something, and you know, he's just so passionate about fishing and loves what he's doing, and. So we're really, really lucky to have Mike, and then Ryan and Sean and Shane have been there for a few years now, and we just have quality people. Dan Kramer's been on the boat now for 12 years. He's one of the chefs, and we have a new chef, Josh, that is really close friends with Mike Totter, and so they're a team, and he's, you know, went to culinary school, and so he's well trained in your culinary needs, and his sauces are just phenomenal.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
Man. So, and that's one of the things about long range fishing, and like on the Searcher, is that you're not only going to have a great platform and great crew to fish with, you're going to eat quite well, right?
Yeah. You know, that's kind of our mission. You know, we work really hard at the things that we can control.
Yeah.
And, you know, the plate of food that gets put in front of you is something that we can control, you know, with fresh ingredients and somebody that cares about what's going out on the plate is important. And, you know, that's that and the crew and the service. It's all about customer service, and that's something that we can control. We can't make the bluefin bite.
Nope.
And sometimes we've struggled with that, even though you see plenty of fish out there, they just don't like what we have to offer.
Right.
And we can't do anything about the weather. There's a little wind event right now. But, you know, we can make sure you're safe. We can make sure the service is good. We can make sure the food is good. We can make sure that your catch is preserved. Those are the things that we can control, and we work hard at them.
Yeah, for sure. So what is the hardest job on a long-range boat, on, like the searcher? Do you think it's the chef, the captain, the crew? I mean, I know that's a tough question, and it's variable. When you ask the chef, it says he's going to say it's his job, but the captain says it's his job.
Well, I think that it's almost equal, you know.
Yeah.
As the captain, you're the master of the vessel. You're responsible for all those lives. Your license is what, you know, allows you to go out there. And so, you know, think
it's
of it incomparable to an airline pilot.
You know?
I mean, you have... You know, an airline pilot's got the piece of equipment, and he or she has got the responsibility of a couple hundred passengers, and
For sure.
That's the same for us. You know, we're responsible for the platform, the boat, and everything that works on the boat and everybody's lives. So that's a huge responsibility, and we certainly don't take that for granted, and that's, you know, safety first. And then, you know, the chef, when it's choppy, they still got to produce those meals that are outstanding. And so that's, you know, I'd rank them, you know, kind of equal as
right
the toughest jobs on the boat. But,
yeah,
you know, we're a team, and everybody chips in wherever we need. You know, the chefs come out on deck and staple fish and help with tangles, and we go in the galley and wash a dish and serve a meal and help load groceries and that sort of thing. So it's all about team searcher.
Yeah, absolutely. I marvel when I go on the searcher at how hard everybody works, man. It is a challenging job. You got to work your tail off.
You do, but it's rewarding.
Yeah.
You know, when you catch something, and you know, it's very gratifying to when you know you're out there looking for fish and you find fish and it bites and everybody's having a great time on the deck and we're tagging fish and hooping it up and just having fun in general. It's very gratifying.
Yeah. You mentioned being captain of the searcher is a rival to being an airline pilot. I think that your job's way harder than an airline pilot, and not to discount how important a job an airline pilot is, but they don't have to worry about fish biting.
True. No, they just got to keep it in the air.
Like
but
they don't have to worry about the fish biting.
Yeah.
But as you can hear, we have a great show lined up for you today. A lot to talk about here on Let's Talk Hookup with Captain Art Taylor of the Searcher. And if you want to join us, hey, you can join us right now, 213-432-1090, 213-432-1090. And, of course, you can also join us on the app. Just download the Let's Talk Hookup app and text the show. Text the show, and we'll get you in there and get your questions for Art. Or if you have a comment or question or anything you want to talk about today, we're here for you on Let's Talk Hookup. And we have a great prize for one lucky caller or texter today. It's a $100 gift certificate to Cal's Custom Reels for reel repair or service by Cal. That's going to be, you can take your reel, send it to Cal, $100. That'll take care of your reel and just make it like a super machine for sure. And when we come back, we're going to have your questions, your texts, your calls, and more from Captain Art Taylor. You stay tuned. This is Southern California Sport Fishing Voice. It's Let's Talk Hookup on the Let's Talk Hookup app and the Mightier 1090 ESPN Radio.
Hey, everybody. This is Captain Dwayne Diego, four-pack charter captain, here to talk to you about Parker Boats and the good folks at West Coast Marine. When it came time to start Pinnacle Sport Fishing and get my own boat, there was only one choice. I wanted a Parker. Then there's a real good reason for it: the fishability and seaworthiness. I've been fishing on Parkers for years now, and I know the abuse they can take. Parker Marine builds a heavy-duty, industrial-strength boat, probably overbuilt, but that's what I need when we're out 12 hours a day, over 300 days a year, running charters. The guys at West Coast Marine built me one heck of a fishing boat. From the custom tower with steering and throttle controls to the backup bait pump system, my Parker 2520 XLD will deliver me to the fishing grounds reliably and safe. Take it from me. If you're ready for a new Parker at a fair, upfront, honest deal, you need to see West Coast Marine, located at 1555 Newport Boulevard in Costa Mesa, or check them out and their inventory and information online at westcoastmarine.com.
Let's talk candidly about long-range fishing. This is Captain Frank DePresti of the Royal Polaris and the Shogun. Nowhere on earth will you find a fleet of long-range boats like we have in San Diego. We are fortunate to have several top-notch operations to take you to the most productive fishing grounds in the world. We all offer good food, comfortable staterooms, huge bait capacity, and top-of-the-line fish-finding electronics. So why would you choose the Royal Polaris or the Shogun for your next long-range trip? What sets us apart from the rest? It's pretty simple. The boats, the crew, and the service. From the moment you arrive at Fisherman's Landing, the service begins. We help you load your gear and do everything possible to get beginners or seasoned veterans ready to catch fish. When it's time to fish, the Royal Polaris and the Shogun have the edge there too, delivering the two best fishing platforms in the fleet. But don't take my word for it. Come fishing with us. If you want the best, it's Royal Polaris and the Shogun. For more information, call 619-226-8030 or on the web at royalpolarissportfishing.com or shogunsportfishing.com.
For your next fishing adventure, check Point Loma Sport Fishing. They offer half-day trips on the Daily Double and full-day trips on the Mission Bell every day. Perfect for novice or seasoned fishermen. Point Loma Sport Fishing also offers overnight to multi-day trips on the American Angler, Vagabond, Intrepid, Independence, New Loan, T-Bird, Game Changer, and more. Visit PointLomaSportFishing.com where you can purchase tickets online. Want to go fishing? Point Loma Sport Fishing has you covered.
This is Captain Dwayne Diego, Pinnacle Sport Fishing. Visual signs are one of our most important aspects to our charter fishing business. It's the reason myself and all of our crew all wear Costa sunglasses. With advanced polarization technology, Costa is designed to help cut through the sun's glare while providing enhanced color and comfort to help you see more fish. Costa was founded over 35 years ago by a group of fishermen wanting high-performance lenses for every fishing application. Costa has a West Coast-style frame and lens for your pursuit. Check them out at CostaSunglasses.com.
I got a garage full of fishing tackle, and every time I get out on the water, I realize I forgot something important. But I never forget my life jacket. I make sure my buddies wear theirs, too. Save the ones you love. A message from California State Parks Division of Boating and Waterways.
Welcome back to Let's Talk Hookup, right here on the Let's Talk Hookup app and the Mighty 1090 ESPN Radio. Captain Art Taylor here from the Searcher. Now, during the break, Art and I were talking about the importance of trip insurance.
Absolutely.
And we've had Bob Dawson on the show many, many times. Bob's service is, it's almost like a must, right? It's like making your reservation for fish processing.
Yeah, get your trip insurance.
Yeah. So why do you need trip insurance?
Well, if you have a, you know, a last-minute medical emergency, or you have a family emergency or something, and you can't make your trip. And, you know, for instance, our limited load 14-passenger trips are $5,000, and you cancel, and our policy is, well, if we can refill your spot, your spot, then we'll get you a refund.
If it's only a couple days away and it's an 8-day trip or a 5-day trip, yeah, good luck with that, right?
Yeah, but if you have trip insurance, then you're covered.
You're covered.
Yeah, I mean, why wouldn't you? I mean, if you're going to Italy for 3 weeks to get trip insurance, and the cost of the trip is comparable to what we're talking about here, you know, you're talking about thousands of dollars, why wouldn't you get trip insurance? It's just a must.
I buy the annual policy.
Yeah.
Because not just for the trip insurance part of it, but also the emergency evac or something goes wrong.
Exactly,
so many factors. So
you're out on a searcher at Tanner Bank and you have a medical emergency and the Coast Guard's got to fly out there in a helicopter to pick you up. There's a charge for that.
Yes. Yeah, it's not free.
It's not free. Or you're down on the ridge or something like that, and you got to run to Mag Bay, and you know a medevac has to fly down to Magdalena Bay, San Carlos, and pick you up. You know, I mean, that those are worst case scenario things.
Oh, but for sure. But it could happen.
It could happen. The obvious one is 2 days before the trip. Let's face it. You test positive for COVID-19.
Right.
You can't go. We're grateful that you're canceling because we don't want you to bring it on the boat.
Right.
But if you have trip insurance, then you're covered.
Yeah. Believe me.
It's a no-brainer.
After just going through that, I thought, you know, double vax, double boosted, I'm good.
Mm-hmm.
I go on a trip, I get COVID.
Yep.
I mean, I thought I was, I'm good. I'm not going to get it. I got it.
Yeah. Same with Celia and I back in January. We got it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So trip insurance, you book a reservation on a boat, you make a reservation for your processor and you get trip insurance. It's really, really inexpensive.
Yes,
compared to what you would lose if we can't refill your spot.
For the so many reasons that we get. Now, when they call and book a trip for a searcher or book it online, can they do that through your office?
Absolutely.
Or they just call Bob Dawson?
There's a link on our website.
Okay, to go to Dawson Insurance.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yep.
And everybody in the fleet uses Dawson.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
If they don't, they should be.
They should, because it's the most reasonable.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
He knows the business. He's a long-range fisherman.
Absolutely.
Yeah. He knows the business for sure. Well, hey, phones are packed. Texts are pouring in, Art. So let's jump into it. Let's start with Vinny in Carlsbad this morning. Good morning, Vinny. Thanks for joining us on Let's Talk Hookup.
Hey, good morning, guys. How are you?
Great.
Yeah, you guys both hit good. You guys both hit on the nose there when you're talking about I booked a trip last year on the RP, and first thing I did after I hung up the phone, I booked the Fisherman's Processing, and my wife and I were going to Alaska, and you know, the Bob Dawson, talked to him on the phone. What a great guy. Just really easy to talk to. And the insurance, you know, so we've got it all covered in case, like you said, we have to do our 48 hours before we go on a trip because we're flying into Vancouver. So we want to make sure that we're negative, and if we pop up positive, one of us does, and hey, we're covered our whole trips. I mean, we spent $15,000 on this trip. Well,
Absolutely.
You know, a few hundred dollars for insurance is nothing. So yeah, but anyways, a few years ago, I went on the searcher, and Art was on the trip, and it was right after COVID. You know, they finally let us go fishing and everything, and Art, Celia, and not sure if Callie's still there, but everybody welcoming with open arms, and you got a professional. And the one thing I got to say, I've been on a lot of long-range boats, and Art, as a captain, you're very cool, calm, collective. I never once saw you raise your voice at any of your crew. You treat them like family, and I know they are to you. You're very professional, and I just wanted to pass it on to you guys.
Well, thanks for the kind word, Vinny. I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
All right. Thanks for the call, Vinny. Appreciate that very much. That does free up 213-432-1090. Open right now. John in Denver is listening to us on the Let's Talk Hookup app, and he says, I'm headed on a 2-day charter this week and have a question on my trolling, my Mad Mac. Ideas on how I should rig these, and can I troll this on a boat like the Searcher?
I'm pretty sure we're trolling those things. And, you know, here's what I would do. You arrive in San Diego, I would go straight to Fisherman's Landing Tackle.
Yep.
Talk to anybody in there, and they can make sure that your Mad Mac is rigged correctly. Now, I don't know if the boat that you're going on trolls those things or allows that. As far as the rigging is concerned, I would make sure that go to Fisherman's Landing Tackle. Those guys rig those things every day, and so they would be the experts to talk to.
Yeah. They say that, you know, trolling it on straight 100-pound, you get bit a little better, but you lose a lot because you hook a big fish and they have teeth and they chafe. So what most guys are doing and rigging it on 200-pound fluorocarbon, like Seaguar fluorocarbon, like 3 to 5 feet of Seaguar fluorocarbon, proper connections. But again, if you don't want to do it yourself, you just, while you're waiting for the load the boat, go in there and say, hey, can you rig my Mad Mac for me?
And the other thing is that, from what I understand, is that, you know, 12 to 14 knots is the speed that you need to troll those things at. So most sport fishing boats that you're going to go on, we don't go that fast.
Yes.
You know, we're trolling at 7.5, maybe 8 knots, and top speed might be 10 or 11 knots. So I don't know if that's a factor, whether it, you know, as far as the action
I think so.
Whether it gets bit or not. So that's something that you should consider as well.
So what are you trolling on the searcher?
We're trolling cedar plugs.
See, of course.
Yeah.
Those things are getting bit, too.
Yeah, they're working.
Cedar plug, daisy chains, and cedar plugs, right?
Yeah, just plain old, you know, we're trying to keep it simple, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, cedar plugs.
And that's stopping the boat.
Well, we're not getting bluefin bites, but it's working around kelps, and, you know, there's some yellowfin tuna around, so, cedar plugs.
Yeah. The advantage, of course, on a long-range boat, or most of the sport boats, is you have sonar. You see them. You see them, right?
Yeah, true. Yeah.
So you can look ahead, look to the side.
Yeah.
You know where they are.
And we're, you know, we're not spending a whole lot of time trolling, you know, because it's, you know, you're going from spot to spot to spot, and a lot of times, you know, there's really not time to put the trollers out and get them set up and do all that sort of thing before you're going to the next spot. So, it's not very efficient as far as timing is concerned.
Yeah, for sure. All right. Appreciate those texts very much. Let's head down south to John Ireland at Rancho Leonero, where we know the fish are biting. Good morning, John.
Good morning, Pedro. Hello, Art.
Nice. Hello, John.
You guys.
Great to hear from you. Is it still continue? Is it still great?
Yeah, the fishing has been very good. Not quite as good as last few weeks. The tuna are a little pickier biters than they have been for the past couple of weeks. They're out. The pods of porpoise are out there holding the tuna. They're just not biting as aggressively as they have in the past few weeks. They're still out there and still around, though, so that bodes well. I mean, it's been so red hot for the past 6 weeks that there had to be a little break in the action. The Dorado bite's still wide open. Big pools. Give you an idea, the Bisbee, they released 67, they didn't release. They kept 67 Dorado over 300 pounds and the Bisbee. The Winfish was 54.7. So the Dorado bite's really, really good. The bill fishing is good, too. The winning fish for the Bisbee was a black, a 375. But there are loads of blues and blacks released between 200 and 300 pounds. So the fishing's been real good. It's but the tuna bite is knocked off a little bit. Rooster fishing's very good as well. Some rooster fish are common. You know, not much pressure because everybody's rolling around outside. But certainly for the Bisbee and all that, looking for the billfish. But really, really good rooster fishing. And big guys, some in the 78 pound range, some really whopper rooster fish, big guys. Nice ones. A few wahoo as well. Not real big ones, 20 to 30 pounders. We're seeing two or three a day to the cleaning table. And they're being picked up amongst everything else. So, I don't think anybody's really been targeted them, but Rapalas are the way to go. Rapalas are the way to go with them. And we're talking about it before. Those cedar plugs are deadly, right? They're the cedar plugs and the hoochies, the elephant are. So, and lots of stripers, lots of sailfish, too. Loads and loads. The sailfish bite is very, very good. The inside banks are what's produced. And so, overall, it's been pretty good. The tournament results, real quick. First marlin, I was 375. Biggest tuna was only 43.1. Big Dorado, 54.7. And the second part was 52.5. I think they're about 70 or over 50 pounds overweight, and loads in the 40s and the 30s. So Dorado fishing is pretty, very good. Big
man. Sounds like great fishing. Yeah. Well, hey, John, if somebody wants to come down to Rancho Leonero, great time of the year from now through November. How do we get a hold of you if we want to grab a spot?
Thanks. 800 It's 646-2252 or RanchoLandArrow.com. We're uploading a lot of photos.
All right. Great to hear from you, John. Appreciate the report, and we'll talk to you next Sunday. Thanks very much. All right. Well, let's go ahead and jump back into those jam-packed phones. They are ready to talk to Art. Logan from Whittier, you're next up on Let's Talk Hookup. Good morning, Logan.
Good morning, guys.
Logan Flaxington.
I just got off my... That is the one and only.
Good morning, Logan. So, how's it going?
Good morning. Pretty good, Art. I just wanted to call and talk about my recent trip aboard the Searcher for 8 days down to Alejos Rocks and the Ridge, fishing those southern zones down there. So we left last Friday, and Captain Mike, the minute we got on the boat, took great care of everyone, making sure everyone was having a great time, accommodated for. And he told us our game plan was to head straight south. And after 2 days of travel, we hit Alejos Rocks for limit-style yellowfin tuna fishing, a fish up to 40 pounds, and we had scatterings of wahoo up to 45 pounds, biting the troll, biting bobs, just all-around good fishing down there. And then on our way back up, we stopped at the Ridge and came across, once again, limit-style yellowtail fishing now that were biting anything from flyline baits to the yo-yo iron, surface iron, and it was all around just a great trip. The Searcher crew, as always, took amazing care of my dad and I, and it was just a blast all around. I'm pretty sure everyone came home to hit limits. If not, they could have had the limits if they wanted. Like I said, it was just an all-around amazing trip aboard the Searcher, and honestly, a great fall-like variety of trip.
That sounds like a great trip, man. That sounds like a fun. And boy, it sounds like your timing was great. Great weather, great fishing. And how did that fish come back after the processor?
Honestly, I'm on my way down back to San Diego to pick my fish up right now. The processors have been so busy, which is great for them, that the wait time was just a little long for us to wait down there. But I'm ready for this fish. Five-star processing, Fisherman's Processing. They always do an amazing job with our product and take care of our fish. And it's always we're always happy when we receive it back.
That's great. Well, enjoy your fish, and glad you had such a good trip.
Thanks, Logan.
All right. Thanks a lot for the call this morning. Very much. Great text here. Appreciate all the texts coming pouring through this morning, and we'll get to all of them. It says, good morning, Pete, Art, and Ricky. Ricky's probably listening, so hopefully, Ricky, you're feeling better. He says, I'll be with you guys in a week from tomorrow on an extended day and a half. Any idea on south or west and what tackle I should bring with me from Randy in Costa Mesa?
Boy, a week out. all options are on the table. Hopefully this kelp patty fishing sustains itself, and so maybe that afternoon, you know, since it's an extended trip, we're leaving at 10 in the morning, 11 in the morning.
Is that what an extended day and a half is?
Yeah,
rather than leaving it in the evening, you leave
right
in the morning.
Mm-hmm. It's basically a two-day trip. And so... you're leaving in the morning, so there might be a chance for a yellowtail on a kelp, or, you know, that bluefin yellowfin tuna mix is around that 302 bank, then there's a chance for that in the afternoon. So you'll be fishing somewhere in the afternoon. And then there's also a possibility that you just blow by all that and get out to where that bluefin tuna is and hopefully get a... you know, an all-night session in flat falling and knife jigs with heavy tackle and that sort of thing. So make sure you've got at least three outfits. I'd have a, you know, 25-pound outfit for fly line and a sardine for a yellowtail and maybe a 40-pound outfit. And then make sure you have an 80- or 100-pound rig with a two-speed reel and make sure you got a couple, three flat fall lures or knife jigs rigged appropriately with a couple hundred-pound leader on it, and that should cover it.
There you go. That sounds like a good trip. So tell us about extended days. Do you do a number of extended day and a half, or they're just randomly in the schedule?
They're randomly in the schedule, and in 2023, our schedule's available. We're calling them two-day trips because that's essentially what they are. Yeah. We're leaving in the morning, and so you get to fish that afternoon.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's in the 2023 schedule, which is now up at searchersportfishing.com.
Correct, yeah. They're two-day trips.
You're calling them two-day trips.
Yeah.
Rather than extended day and a half.
Exactly, yeah.
Which makes sense.
Yeah, we're leaving in the morning
So on that two-day trip, you leave in the morning, you've got the afternoon, you got all the next day, and then you come back the following morning.
That's correct, exactly.
Yeah. So it truly is a two-day trip.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for sure. So that Searcher Sport Fishing schedule is up. Can you book any trip, or are you the trips that haven't gone yet, do the people that are on that trip have first shot at it, or how is the schedule working this year?
Well, this year we put the schedule out.
Because you're sold out this year. You can't.
Yeah, get on a wait list.
Get on a wait list, and I should stress that. If you see that it's sold out, call the office and get on the wait list.
Get on a wait list. You can book online and get on a wait list.
Oh, you can book right online at searchersportfishing.com. Mm-hmm. Okay.
We put out our schedule to all our regular customers, so they got a sneak peek at the 2023 schedule 3 weeks, almost 4 weeks prior to having it go live on the website. So July 5th, the schedule came out to all our regular customers. Everybody got an email. You know, book now, reserve your spot for 2023. And then a month later, we came out and made it live on the website.
Wow. So you can book any trip now for 2023 that has availability.
Yeah, the full schedule is up.
And I'll bet they're filling up quickly.
There's quite a few sold out trips already. So
I'll bet.
I wouldn't wait too long.
Don't wait too long. Now, speaking of sold out trips, you know, most of the boats, the quality boats, are sold out. And unfortunately, our good friend John Conniff and Peter and the crew over at the Islander had to cancel all their shark trips at Guadalupe because of the Guadalupe permits. It's just a
horrible thing. Yeah,
really a tough thing, and I don't know. It's a shame that the Mexican government decided to do that. But
it is.
It is what it is. You know.
Yep.
And the fact that you guys paid all your permits, you have all your permits, everything is secluded. But there's somebody in there that they want to do like a study of Guadalupe.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. So while they're studying, they shut the whole thing down for everybody.
Yeah, so, for 2022.
For 2022.
May 1st to December 1st is the season. So they suspended all recreational activities, sport fishing and shark diving, shark viewing. So, the whole season's gone.
The whole season. So, unfortunately, the Islander had to cancel all of their shark trips, which we feel for the Islander. They worked very hard, but the good news for anglers is they just opened up their schedule for September, October, and November. Trips are online at fishermanslanding.com right now. You can book online right now on... They have day and a half trips, they have extended day and a half trips, and they have 3-day limited load trips available right now at fishermanslanding.com. Just when you go to Fisherman's Landing on the schedule, just put in Islander, and all those trips will pop up, and those are going to go very quickly.
I'm sure of it.
Yeah.
With the fishing being the way it is, and can't say enough about John Conniff. He's one of my favorite people in the industry, a great colleague, always very helpful, and great family guy, and he really takes good care of that boat. We're neighbors. We park next to each other, so we're always bouncing stuff off of each other and keeping boats. You know, his is a Ditmar Donaldson, too, so we have a lot in common there, and so we share ideas, and that Islander is in such great condition, and it's a great platform, and I'm sure he's going to do great with September, October, and November.
Yeah, excellent operation.
Absolutely.
Captain Peter and both John are just fantastic captains.
Yeah, Pete is such a great guy. He is, they're just a joy. They're great neighbors. They're just a joy to be around. Great colleagues. and work hard, and the boat's in great condition, and yeah, they're going to do fine. And
yeah, so if you want to book on the Islander, fishermanslanding.com, September, October, November, are now available online. Grab them while you can, because I guarantee you they're going to quickly. So the good news is, for that, I mean, it's bad news, good news situation, but the good news is we had to cancel our Islander kayak mothership trip that we had in May. We've rescheduled that trip for September 13th through 15th. So those of you that are on that trip with us will be getting hearing from me very shortly. But you can mark your calendar for November 13th through 15th. That day and a half trip on the schedule is actually our trip. It's not for
November
sale.
Or September?
September. September 13th through 15th. It's a Tuesday through Thursday. Leave Tuesday night, fish Wednesday, back Thursday morning. That's going to be our Islander kayak trip. And like I say, for all the people that are on that trip, you'll be hearing from me very shortly about the nice. Rescheduling of that trip. All right. And when we come back, we're going to talk more from the searcher, more fishing information, and get a catch report. You stay tuned. This is Southern California Sport Fishing Voice. It's Let's Talk Hookup on the Let's Talk Hookup app and the Mightier 1090 ESPN Radio.
The name that stands out among anglers is Fisherman's Landing, your top choice in local and long-range fishing. Hi, this is Doug Kern. Our hardworking crew will make sure your fishing experience is one to remember. We offer the finest open party trips from 1 to 3 days, the best charter boats available, and of course, our world-renowned long-range fleet is second to none. Fisherman's Landing is a full-service operation offering great half-day trips on the Dolphin and full-day open party trips on the spacious and comfortable Liberty. Since we introduced the full-day trips at Fisherman's Landing, the 85-foot Liberty has become a favorite among full-day operations with bunks for your comfort, huge bait capacity, and RSW fish holds to keep your catch fresh. Plus, Liberty has a big modern galley and two interior heads with showers. All our open party trips from half-day, full, or 1 to 3 day trips can easily be booked online at fishermanslanding.com or give us a call at 619-221-8500. I'll see you at Fisherman's Landing in San Diego.
Hey, it's time to talk about great gear from Shimano, and everybody's always looking for the hot lure, and you know the ones that are really getting fish on the boat. Well, right now, the bluefin tuna bite is on, and the Shimano Pop Orca and Pock Orca Slim are getting the job done. Pop Orca features Shimano's unique bubble chamber, an open-mouth design based on a jet engine, turns into low pressure into high pressure, and the bubble chamber forces the water through the chamber and shoots it out the top to create more commotion than conventional style popper lures. This unique style of Pop Orca and Pop Orca Slim makes it much easier to work than a conventional popper. Now, through wire constructions, high tensile strength hooks, Shimano Pop Orcas can stand up to that large bluefin tuna. Plus, with jet boost technology, it'll help anglers increase their casting distance. You can reach the foamer much easier with the Shimano Pop Orca and Pop Orca Slim. Get them now at your local Shimano dealer and start catching more fish.
Hey, this is Rosie with Cedros Sport Fishing. We have always been the leader in fishing trips to Cedros Island. We have set the bar even higher with our second lodge opening for the 2022 season. Side-by-side lodges sitting on the cliff's edge with relaxing ocean views. With direct flights departing through the CBX in San Diego, we are committed to providing first-class service to our guests and an unforgettable fishing experience. Come check out the yellowtail and calico bass capital in the world. Nobody does it better than Cedros Sport Fishing. Call me at 619-772-7570 or check us out at cedrosportfishing.com.
When you want to catch big bluefin tuna, you need Shimano. Hi, this is Doug Kern from Fisherman's Landing Tackle, the saltwater tackle professionals. The Shimano Beastmaster is the pinnacle of electric reels. Shimano's Gigamax motor packs a winding strength up to 250 pounds, ideal for kite fishing and more. Shimano's butterfly flatfall jigs are irresistible to bluefin tuna because they stay in the strike zone longer. Shimano makes a complete line of butterfly flatfall jigs to target your favorite game fish. For all your Shimano needs, visit us at Fisherman's Landing Tackle at Fisherman's Landing in San Diego.
Welcome back to Let's Talk Hookup. Hey, time to find out what's spotting out there. The catch report today, sponsored by Gamakatsu. Top anglers know the best hooks are made by Gamakatsu. But did you know Gamakatsu also makes amazing tackle storage solutions like the G-Box 3200 reversible utility case for easy, tangle-free jig storage? Gamakatsu also makes jig heads, a line of fishing pliers, clothing, and so much more. They even make knives now. For the complete lineup, check Gamakatsu.com or your local tackle dealer. here, and we have a couple of Gamakatsu Searcher Sport Fishing trips coming. One coming up very soon that Gamakatsu is providing a lot of great hooks and gear for too.
Yeah, it's nice to have a selection of hooks that just help yourself to. It's great.
Oh yeah, no, Gamakatsu has been a great supporter of ourselves and Searcher too. And let's start up at Dana War Sport Fishing. Captain Brian Woolley's on the line. Good morning, Captain Woolley.
Hey, good morning, guys. How are you both this morning?
Hey, doing morning, terrific.
Doing
How's that fishing?
Good. Hey, you know, we plowed through another good week up here. Our half-day action, Pete, I know you like to surf, but I don't know if you got out on the water this week, but, man, that big swell pushed onto the beach this week. And, you know, our stretch of beach is pretty much all south-facing, so we had some big areas that just washed out coast below the harbor there, which made things a little tricky on that half-day scene. Our water temps bounced around a bit or two with that movement and, of course, that wind the last couple of days. So our water temps ranged from, like, 64 to 71 this week. So it was kind of all over the place, depending on where we were there. Bass fishing, like I said, was a little bit tougher as a result of that swell. However, we did have some nice fish on live baits. Our live bait this week, we're fishing, like, 5-inch sardine. And, you know, we caught bass on it, a little bit better grade of fish on that sardine. It was just tougher to get the bites having to fish that bigger bait for some of our guys and some of our rental people. More sheephead for the guys fishing the sinker rigs and a couple halibut in the mix as well. You know, those guys soaking those bigger baits on the bottom were rewarded with a couple nice halibut. And a few days this week, you know, we did fold in some deeper water, targeting some rockfish to kind of mix it up a little bit and, you know, kind of just out of necessity with those trickier conditions along that inshore stretch for us. And then offshore, off the beach, gosh, some fantastic opportunities there. The Furies had a great week getting in on that kelp patty fish, that nice, I mean, for kelp patty yellowtail, the quality has been phenomenal. And some really good mahi in his counts as well. Gosh, we're seeing a tremendous amount of this Dorado, too, up in our zone from, you know, just east of the, you know, the end of Catalina there all the way down through all those offshore banks. So just a tremendous amount of this fish. And you know, if this stuff ever settles in and wants to bite, it's going to be really fun for us. So we do have more offshore trips on the books this week. So if someone wants to hop on that, certainly make those reservations. But gosh, plenty of kelps in schools of this fish to get the boat stopped on. It's just, it's been racy. It hasn't really been biting very well, but the show has definitely been there. So we're fingers crossed that we see some of that. And our six-pack charter fleet had some really solid shots at that bluefin between the islands this week. Some fish on the, you have to call it traditional now, but the vintage flying fish setups, because everyone's out there trolling those high-speed jigs. So those guys are catching plenty on that high-speed program too. So fish on the hoppers and the surface lures as well for our six-pack fleet. But just all in all, a good mixed kind of, you know, opportunity for us up here this week. So fingers crossed that the wind is, that's in the forecast this week, isn't too much, and we can keep keep the ball rolling. So
yeah, for sure.
Want to hop on a trip? Yeah, reservations for sure a must. Call our landing here 949-496-5794. Of course, you can check us out on the web too at danawharf.com.
All right, great job, Captain Woolley, and we'll talk to you next Sunday.
Okay, have a great week, guys.
All right. Thank you. You too. And let's head down to Cedros Island, talk to Jeff Flowers. Good morning, Jeff. I wish Ricky was here today to talk about his great trip down to Cedros, but you can just cover that, okay?
Sounds good. Actually, I'm sitting here just enjoying listening to the two of you guys. I'm gonna talk to Rosie again if she walked out here, and we're sitting in the backyard, and I want to jump on Art's boat and go fish with him.
Yeah, no kidding, right? Me too.
Yeah. Been on my bucket list for a while. So, hey, wow, what a great week down there. I'm sure Ricky probably talked to you on the side, but great fishing again, great weather, fish biting down on the south end and on the north end. It's kind of take your choice, a little bit bigger fish up north. But there is a new record that was set down on the island this last week.
Whoa.
63.3 pounds yellowtail.
Holy mackerel. I thought it was going to be deer consumption, but it's a record on the yellowtail, huh?
Well, you know, unfortunately or fortunately, however you look at it, when we went through the tournament down there a couple weeks ago, we wiped that island out on beer.
So,
they're still trying to play the catch up.
Yeah. 63-pound yellowtail, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's just, you know, makes you lay in bed at night thinking, how are you going to wind something in like that in 60 feet of water? So, or less. So it's great fishing down there. Again, you know, it sounds like a broken record every Sunday afternoon or Sunday morning, depending on where you're at listening to the show. But, it's just, I, you can't even describe the words. It's magical. Getting down there and being a part of that old school Mexico vibe, getting to see the island, getting to meet some of the people, humble people down there, family people, you know, they're making a living. And, you know, you get a chance to see that and then go out and have some of the best world-class fishing you'll ever find.
And the other thing that Ricky was telling me, Jeff, is how easy everything is now. Rosie makes it so easy. I remember the old days where you used to have to drive to Ensenada and wait for the fly. And now you just drive down to CBX, you get on the plane, and you're there in a matter of like an hour and a half, and you're fishing that afternoon. It's so much easier than it used to be, and Cedro Sport Fishing makes it easier than it's ever been. So if somebody wants to go fishing with you, are there any spots available?
You know, there are, and that's what's amazing is this is coming up on what I consider the best fishing time of the year down there.
Oh, yeah.
And we got a couple of trips or a couple spots open right now, and a trip that leaves on the 15th. And Rosie's in search of trying to find a couple people to fill that spot.
15th of August?
Handfuls.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, in a week. Week tomorrow. And so it's actually on a trip I'm going to be on. We'd be down there having some more fun with my son and a few friends. So relaxing trip. But the other thing, too, I wanted to point out is that on the Mexican side of the airport, they have done a wonderful job this last year rebuilding a new section to the airport. It's world-class. It's first-class and easy to get through. The concierge that Rosie has down there that works with us, they make it super, super simple. Once you cross that bridge, you can't make a mistake. You can get on that plane, be blindfolded, and it's easy, very easy. So if you want to get a hold of Rosie, find out what is open, you can reach her easiest on her cell, and that's 619-772-7570, or you can go on the website. But please, if you go to the website, there's a lot of people down there that are trying to copy what we're doing. They're stealing our name, blah, blah, blah. Make sure you're going to SedrosSportFishing.com.
And the easiest way is just to go to letstalkhookup.com, go on the links page, click on the Cedro Sport Fishing app. It'll take you to the right spot. Jeff Flowers, great job. Appreciate that very much. And we will talk to you next Sunday.
You guys have a great day. It's beautiful outside. Enjoy it.
All right. Thanks. All right. Let's head to the surf. Surf guru Gundy Gunderson's on the line. Good morning, Gundy.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Great. How are you?
Pretty good. Pretty good. A little glum when we got that swell kind of messed things up on the beach. But, boy, we rebounded over the weekend.
I don't know. I liked it.
Yeah. You still can get on that surfboard, Pete?
Hard to believe, isn't it?
Yeah, let's jump into it. Like I said, another swell event this week really affected the surf, especially on the south-facing beaches. Now, some of the west-facing beaches saw the better catches, especially that Carpinteria to Torrance stretch there, real consistent. And, you know, we talked about this last week. The water temps are still in the mid-60s up above, so they're still seeing lots of bait. And the southern beaches, you know, let's say Dana Point South, starting to see that water push into the 70s and that bait starting to dissipate, you know. So we're seeing a little bit of a change here. Hook, Line, Sinker reported good Corvina catches from Carpinteria to Oxnard. Lots of sand crabs, 1 to 3 fish in a session, which is good fishing for up north there. Still lots of sea bass catches this week, just not too many illegals, just a handful reported. Wiley's reported wind and swell, but a quick bounce back. Big Rock, El Pescador, El Matador, the reefed beaches up there, west facing, were the best fishing. Lots of calico bass, and we talked about some big fish last week. They had some fish up to 4 pounds this week. Some sand bass, yellowfin croaker, tons of sargo, and some cabazon mixed in. Just fishing down in Redondo reported a 12-pound striped bass taken off the harbor jetty there. The fish fell for a bloodworm. A good spot fin bite on a Huntington Pier reported from Big Fish. Muscle taking fish to 5 pounds. Ketchum Tackle kind of had the short end of the stick this week. Lots of junk in the water, ripping current there. You know, the peninsula kind of pokes out a little bit, and when you get a big swell, they get it a little worse. Hogan's reported good Corvina action below the San Clemente Pier. One angler took 3 fish on Friday, 3 fish on Saturday, 4 fish from 18 to 22 inch, so really good quality fish. Spot fin biting at Bellini there. 6-pound fish taken on a ghost shrimp at dusk on Friday. Pacific Coast reported good Corbina action. The shop launched the Corbina Derby the first of the month, and they already have a 4-pound, 12-ounce fish posted. So it's going to be a good one. It might take something over 5 to win that Derby, Pete. But,
mackerel.
You know, that Corbina action, I tell you, the quality's there. It's time to strike.
Yeah, it sounds good, Gundy. And yeah, surf forecast this week, pretty flat this week, so it could be much better for surf fishermen, for sure. Not as good for surfers, but good for surf fishermen. But Gundy Gunderson, surf guru extraordinaire, thanks a lot for that, and we'll talk to you next Sunday.
Yeah, sorry about the surfboard crack. I probably couldn't even get on a boogie board.
Yeah, I don't know. Ron Lane and I call it the fountain of youth. Going to keep on trying as long as I can.
Heck yeah. All right, have a good week.
Thanks, Gundy. Appreciate that very much. And that wraps up our catch report today. And I want to tell you about join BD Outdoors on August 10th. That's this coming Wednesday for a SoCal surf fishing webinar hosted by Benji Kim, Anthony Kaluni, and Bill Varney. This show will include information on rigging, baits, and rod and reel suggestions and how to find fish on the beach. You'll need to sign up for this free online webinar. You just go to bdoutdoors.com and register today. And when we come back, more from Captain Art Taylor, more fishing talk here on Let's Talk Hookup, Southern California Sport Fishing Voice on the Mightier 1090 ESPN Radio and the Let's Talk Hookup app.
Here's John Ireland for Rancho Llanero.
The ranch is small, you know. It's very personal, very intimate. I don't think there's anywhere else that you could have the old Baja feel and have all those miles of beachfront, the palapa roofs and the stone walls. There's not a room that you don't have some kind of ocean view. You don't give up any amenities at the ranch. It's just very rustic. You know how when you cook outdoors, it tastes better? Well, that's Rancho Llanero. It just tastes better. We have paddle boards. We've got kayaks. We've got snorkeling equipment, of course. We've got 12 super pagas. We have dive trips. We've got over 40 kayaks at the hotel. We've got all accurate equipment, very top of the line. And when the fishing's good, we'll freeze your fish, pack it all up, send it home with you. People love it. They'll come back 5-6 times a year. That's the highest accolade we can get. 1-800-646-2252. 646-BAHA. And RancholandAero.com. It's unique.
For quality, the Islander out of Fisherman's Landing is a favorite among anglers. But Islander Charter is much more than great fishing. They also do incredible Guadalupe white shark diving trips, as well as a schedule of kayak mothership trips. Check out Islander-Charters.com. The Islander is San Diego's leader when it comes to 1.5 to 5-day fishing. Experience the Islander difference. Visit Islander-Charters.com for all the details.
The future comes standard at your San Diego County Ford dealers, so swing on by and check out the legendary Ford F-150, the smart and capable Ford Ranger, and the all-new Ford Bronco Sport. New inventory is arriving daily, and your San Diego County Ford dealer is here to help you build and order the truck or SUV of your dreams. Want to make sure you get the right truck to tow your boat? They'll help you order the right configuration to meet your needs. Want to make sure you get the right SUV to haul your gear on your next adventure? They've got you covered there too. Escape, Edge, Bronco Sport, Explorer, and Expedition. They've got the SUV that's perfect for you. If it isn't on the lot, they'll order it and get you exactly what you need. They want your trade, so swing by your nearest San Diego County Ford dealer or visit buyfordnow.com to see all the great deals. They'll be glad to hook you up.
One of the dream trips for most anglers is Alaska. There are so many lodges. How do you make a choice? It's easy. Choose the one most Let's Talk Hookup listeners return to time after time. Kingfisher Charters in Sitka, Alaska. No one does it better than Kingfisher Charters. They offer the best service, the most comfortable accommodations, fantastic food, and the finest charter captains in Sitka. All for the ultimate value. One visit and you will understand why nobody beats Kingfisher Charters. Sitka is famous for some of the best runs of salmon in Alaska. And if giant Alaskan halibut is your target. The expert captains at Kingfisher Charters know the hot spots and can put you on a fish of a lifetime. Plenty of rockfish and huge ling cod are there too. And when it comes to fish processing, the best in Alaska is Kingfisher Charters. It's all included in your package. In fact, everything is included except tips. It is truly amazing how the Kingfisher crew continues the quality of service they deliver year after year. Kingfisher Charters, 800-727-6136 or check kingfishercharters.com.